Public hearing for county budget for next year, or next fiscal year, 2012-2013. So we have a motion to open the public hearing.
Were you making the motion? I'll make the motion to open the public hearing.
I'll second.
What time was that scheduled?
9.
Okay, yeah.
So, yeah, I didn't see any date down here, so. Okay. I seconded that, so all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, we are now in public hearing for our upcoming annual budget starting July 1st. If anybody wishes to speak or has any questions in regards to the budget.
No, you can come up here, whatever. Get on camera this way.
I assume, did you have any handout, anything to anybody or ahead of time?
I did not yet. I don't think anybody ever come and ask for anything.
Okay. Do you have any copies of it?
All I have is this.
Just what was published in the paper?
No. This is the what the tells what the levies are.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Go ahead. Hi, Randy.
Randy Plyma, and I'm here to ask a question. If in the budget there's support again for the Rust Board dues for the upcoming year that you've been part of in the past?
I think. In non-departmental, I think there was $5,000 plugged in for the rest, which was what was given last year, I believe.
I guess my comment is I don't see why Mahaska County needs to be a part of it. They will never use their services, as Mahaska Water is taking care of all the sewer in Mahaska County in light of their problems. And last year there was debate about this on the budget that you guys approved it with 1 year to do it last year with the idea of being able to step out of it or get out of it because it's not ever going to be used. And I just don't feel it's a wise use of Mahaska County taxpayer dollars and for an organization that's never going to be used. And in light of their problems, that Mahaska County should not be part of that for the upcoming year because it's for a service that will never be provided to Mahaska County because we've taken all in Mahaska County, we've done all the incorporated towns are under Mahaska Water sewer problems. So that they were formed to help counties take care of small town sewer problems. But Mahaska is all taken care of by us. You know, we don't ask for handouts or money to manage it. So, and then we've also done subdivision unincorporated areas. So I just don't feel that needs to be part of. And I think it's time to get stepped out of there in light of their problems, and even though they said you can't, I disagree with that, but that's my comment.
Yeah, well, I agree. I know there's one other county that I think is pursuing the situation, who's in the same situation basically as Mahaska County, that
Davis County was going to pull out, and they formed their own to take care of around ADLM is their main issue.
Yeah, and I don't, yeah, but I don't think Mahaska County, like you say, I think all the incorporated areas have done. And it was
formed to help incorporated small towns be able to provide sewer systems if there's management of sewer systems. They're under investigation and stuff for mismanagement and what's going on. I just feel it's time to get out while it's needed, you know, not as a... As a director of Mahaska Rural Water and also as a citizen, you know, I feel it's, you know, we're doing what needs to be done at the time.
And I know we got a notice, I think, last year. I think it shows that we did give the $5,000. We've received another notice just because their ongoing situation with lawsuits going on that they've requested another $2,000. As of the end of December, I don't think we paid anything in regards to that. Or
I thought it was 1,000, but then maybe it was 2. I thought it was 1. It was 2. Okay.
Yeah. They're requesting more.
Was it 2?
It was 2. I'm pretty sure that's what was published in the Des Moines Register there on Christmas Eve.
I saw the bill.
Now,
what is our obligation there? They're talking about it in the Des Moines Register at Christmas. That there was a 40-year obligation. obligation for that?
Well, and that's to answer both your questions, or at least in as much as I'll try. You're right, Randy, a year ago, and of course, this was all new to me. I didn't know what Russ was a year ago, but and agreed to stay with it because I simply didn't want to be knee-jerk about it. Nothing's improved. I think their ongoing problems have as much to do with people wanting them to fail as actually failing, but there's probably been some fault on both sides. We just, Willie, of course, has been our board member on there. Certainly, I think we have to see what that amounts to. What does it take to get out of there? I don't think we want to be knee-jerk. There's long-term agreements, and I think it's time to pursue those things. I will go to the next Rust board meeting. I've never been to one, but as an alternate now, I'll go and try to begin seeing how we can extricate ourselves from that.
Because a 40-year agreement, that would be tied only to the loans that small communities have signed on their behalf. I don't think they can mandate you to pay dues to an organization that you don't want to be there. The only downside, dealing with rural development things in the past, if one of those systems would fail or they have an opportunity to write it down, or then they would come back to the 10 counties to support if they can't make their payments. You would be liable possibly for making a full payment if they become not there. But you know, the dues is just as part of trying to run the management of it, and that's been an issue over the last quite a few years. You know, I could see, you know, to me, your liability could be to make up deficient payments if one of the small communities can't make it, you know, the 10 county there or the Rust board would have to. But as far as paying ongoing management, I disagree with that part of it.
Yeah,
and I don't think our dues are supposed to be used for the ongoing management of, even to begin with, what was initially, because I think those ongoing costs were supposed to be built in and built back to the communities to support the ongoing expenses and the management of. So that's why I was kind of surprised that, I mean, from the 1,000 to the 5,000.
Well, I don't think there's any disagreement that this is a year that we have to figure out how to deal with that, because it's not working for Mahaska County. I don't think that's disputable. So,
and I didn't support a year ago. I put it on the agenda a couple times to get back out of it, but didn't have any support on it at that time. And then I think it progressed, and now they are in a lawsuit with it. So I think maybe that picture changes a little bit once they are in a lawsuit.
The same thing. I just want to make sure it doesn't happen like last year. You said you were going to look into it. Nothing did. You know, Willie is chair. Nothing became part of that. And if you're going, we need to look at it.
Yeah.
And find it, because I know
that will be my purpose of going
as county sanitarian to get some information. I know quite a bit about it.
Yeah.
And they will not respond back or give any information. And here you're a part of it, and they won't give any information of what's going on, maybe through Willie, but Willie hasn't been willing to share that on anybody else. So that's my concern. Where's my concern about that?
Okay, thank you.
Point well taken, absolutely.
Any other questions, comments?
Got a question for you. What's going to be the levy rate on the general and rural? And is it up or down, or which way did it go?
Well, the general is $3.50, which is the same as it's been.
Okay, that's max. What about the supplemental?
Supplemental is going from 95 cents down to 40 cents per thousand.
How were you able to drop that?
Because we have revenue from the local option sales tax that wasn't back from the schools, that wasn't there before. So, and that was by referendum, help me if I'm wrong here, that was to go to property tax relief when those funds were available.
And what that was, it's around numbers, it's about $480,000, $500,000 per year, but we signed an agreement with the city of Oskaloosa and the Oskaloosa school district that we had a 28E agreement, and once that got to the point where the revenues could start coming back to the city and the county for their cooperation in supporting the, building the local elementary school and the renovation of the high school project, that that money would start coming back.
Now, is that just from the Oskaloosa School District?
Correct, yeah.
What about the other school districts?
It all depended on what those 2080 agreements were written, and those 2080 agreements were not written like Oskaloosa's was, where there was a local option sales tax board, and then where that renovation goes back to. So it was a different, it went into a different fund to pay down their bonds and for other usage in the other school districts. And some of them used it for, like, I think New Sharon used it for economic development. So I think 25% of that sales tax goes into New Sharon's economic development fund up there. So those, the other seven 2080 agreements that we had with the other seven school districts were not structured like Oskaloosa's was, nor was it anywhere near the dollar amount that Oskaloosa's was.
Okay, the money that comes from the Oskaloosa School District, we have to divide that over the whole county because it's property tax relief, right?
Correct.
So the whole county benefits from us, but we don't get the benefit from the other school districts, is that right?
That's correct, but it's my understanding this all goes back to the original language in the referendum.
That's right.
Okay,
and we, at this point, we can't go back and change that.
Right, I'm just trying to understand the situation here. So from what we get from our school district, it goes countywide, but the other school districts get to keep that for their own self.
That question came up a couple of months ago here in the board and was researched, and we had to go back to the original language, so our hands are tied on that in terms of reinterpreting how that money should be spent.
And there was some discussion back when that ballot issue was that it's countywide, and since you know, a lot of it comes to Oskaloosa, a lot of people shop in Oskaloosa, and so where the bulk of the sales tax comes from is Oskaloosa, just kind of like when they switched the silo tax statewide, which was the 10-year tax. Des Moines was getting basically all of Iowa's benefit and building their schools. Now that it's a similar situation, a lot of people go to Des Moines and shop. That money that's collected in Des Moines for that school tax, which was building Des Moines schools, now it's generated and spread back out to the statewide average from the Des Moines School District. And I think that's why the Des Moines School District, a lot of those school districts, once that money starts going away, there's a drastic drop in their revenues. So it's kind of a similar situation as that. I think when the discussion was, the bulk of, a lot of people come to Oskaloosa, the bulk of the sales tax comes from Oskaloosa. And so if those people do, that's a way of getting money back to those people with property tax relief for shopping in Oskaloosa and where the bulk of the sales tax comes from.
So we got a drop in supplemental, what? How much was that?
55 cents.
55
drop.
Cents.
I'm right on that. Okay. This was the final number, the 40 cents, right?
Yes.
Okay. Dropping from 95 cents to 40 cents.
Okay. What about the rural levy?
It stayed the same.
395.
Any supplemental?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Some of the sheet that had a big one.
This one?
Yeah, I had the white one in here, I think. But see, that is a pink though. This is from the back side of one of these. Yeah, that was the one I was looking for.
You should have had a pink one.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
You talking about this same sheet?
Yeah, that purple one
you
have.
Well, mine's white, but you guys don't
see it. Yeah, I don't see it.
Well, I don't think that was in this packet.
Yeah, I don't think it was in the packet.
No, it wasn't in this one. I had this other one.
I did have a white one there. We like that. They had it one time, I know. They had it back 10 years ago.
Here's my white one. I want to look at that.
Yeah, that's okay. I've got it somewhere. Anybody else has any questions or comments in regards to the county? county budget. So, and what that is too, just a little more information on that, that Joe, the originally was for 15 years that where there were two taxes, there was the, we had the 5% sales tax. And then 2001, the county approved a 1 cent for the local option sales tax and a 1 cent for the silo tax for the school. And so the county's local option sales tax was for 15 years. The school, which I believe was a silo tax, could only go for 10 years. And I think that just expired, I think, on that, the end of December, and so I think starting January 1st. And so then what happens is that those school districts, then they roll into the statewide average. So I believe the Oskaloosa School District is rolling in then, and now is in that statewide, which I think then that's where they get a little extra money coming from the statewide distribution, is that. So otherwise, if they would have not have had the, if the state would not have approved the 1 cent statewide sales tax, then what would have happened is the Oskaloosa School Districts probably would have needed to, a couple years ago, started doing preliminary work to re-get it on the ballot to potentially reapprove another 10 years of that 1 cent sales tax, because they still have some outstanding bonds, I believe, to pay on. And so the local school districts would have probably re-upped that since their 10 years just expired. So, but with that, so the agreement that we signed, I think it was last April or May, and was reported about last May or something with Oskaloosa and the Oskaloosa School District, then that goes through the balance of the 15 years, the original, and so that will go until through about 2016, I think it's December of 2016 was what that agreement was. So Oskaloosa and Mahaska County will receive whatever that revenue is, but it's currently it's running, I think, about $480,000 a year, roughly $500,000 a year. That's why the, and I think that drops what, 50, 55 cents basically, is about 55 cents, I think, is what that drops, roughly the levy for that property tax relief in the general.
But in 4 years, that will go away.
In 4 years, that goes away, and so that's the...
Then you'll have to raise it back up, right? Probably.
Then something's going to happen with that levy. Yeah, something's going to have to be decided at that point, because then that sales tax will go away.
Is that an issue to be re-voted to see if they want to continue it, or?
That there could be multiple things. You know, the first one was for the jail and the library. This last one was basically for property tax relief for the county. I think the city put in for infrastructure. I think they're going towards streets and the elementary. And so it depends on what the ballot issue is. So numerous things could be done, but just depends on what comes forward and if anything is presented to continue.
Yeah, I mean, it's something that needs to be considered in the not too distant future, because it will impact property tax rates 4 years down the road.
Any other questions, comments, concerns?
Move to close the public hearing.
I'll second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Got it? Opposed? Okay. We are back on our county budget.
Okay. You need a motion to approve the budget. It's all been... it was.
And that's been published?
Published, yes.
Which one? Oh, you have the paper there.
Yeah, I just got one out of the paper. This is.
This is not the same as what was in the paper. It's the sheet that I just gave you. No, this is what has the levies on it. This is the adoption version.
Oh, okay. Is that on? Yeah, that's the same one we've had.
You have one?
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Two signed copies of it.
I move to approve that budget for fiscal year 2013.
One quick question, so just so that I'm straight, you know, going back to the Russ budget, we were talking about that. So if we go ahead and approve that budget, then that means we're going to move forward and pay the full $5,000 again this year for the services that aren't provided, plus the $1,000 come July 1st?
We're going to have to deal with that.
I'm just questioning. That's why we brought it up.
It's in the budget, to answer your question.
Right.
And for those of you that have been around longer, I understand the concerns and the questions. It's somewhat circumstantial. Willie's not here at all to go through this stuff right now. And a year ago, I frankly needed to get up to speed on it. And we did serve notice that a year down the road we needed to look at it. But I don't know that we haven't taken action prior to approving the budget here, so it's in the budget for now. So
I just wanted to make sure that I'm straight. We're going to pay for a service that we don't get another year.
Just because it's in the budget doesn't necessarily mean that they'll pay it.
Okay.
But if it's in there, that's the next concern. What happened the year before that? What happened was Lawrence and I didn't approve it, and they wanted $5,000, and we cut it to $1,000, which $1,000 is what we had always paid.
Right.
On it, but
it just to me, when we do have a local entity that provides all those services, and we continue to provide to other counties that would actually benefit from the program. I'm not saying Russ is actually a good program. It is. It just. In our county, we're fortunate enough to have a municipal here, Mahaska for Water, that provides all those services. So it's just hard for me to see us spend county money to an entity that doesn't offer services that we already have locally, where the money is turned right back around in the county. That's my concern, I guess. So I'm just curious, and I understand.
Well, I think we've answered it, Eric.
Yeah, right.
How many times do we need to answer?
Okay, that's fine. I'm just asking.
Came in two copies, yeah, so I just like two. That was one copy, and then I just hold the other copy over here. Just like, okay, here you go, give me your copies there. But Kay was one signed, and we need two. Anyway, one other thing that I had a question on, which I think it was included and published in there too, was on emergency management. In the emergency management budget, I think was it plugged in that we were going to levy 10 cents on that? And I just had a question on why, or Jamie's here too, why we need to levy the 10 cent levy. I think when the supervisors talked about it, that was up to a 10 cent levy. And what would happen is if the county levies that 10 cent levy, we did do a dollar and a half is what we were doing. I think if we go up to that, the 10 cent levy, that would effectively increase almost four times. It'd be over $4 per capita. The county was levying a dollar and a half per capita as well as all the communities. If we went to a 10 cent levy, that would be about $91,000, I think. And if we divide that back out, that's over $4 per capita, so that would almost, it would definitely more than triple. So it'd be about 3.5 times per capita for the county to levy that much. I just question if we need the full 10 cent levy, or if that levy can cut back. That was what I questioned at the time when I voted no on increasing that levy up to the 10 cent levy. Ken and Willie voted for that, but at that time it was up to a 10 cent levy. I don't know that it was established that it was a 10 cent levy.
Why did this come up in our budget hearings in January? Because we went through all of the budget matters then. We've gone through that, what was it, in November or so, Jamie?
Yes, sir.
And the board decided to go to that levy. So
to plug that.
It's been underfunded for several years, and we have, we'll have to take that like every other budget matter, year by year.
But it's up to a 10-cent levy, but at that time, Jamie hadn't published his budget in the newspaper either, as well. And that's the thing, if going off of Jamie's budget that he published in there, and then what happened was when we had the time and we did the discussion on with the 10-cent levy, then initially, then Jamie and Paul went back to the Emergency Management Board, because we had discussion about what their ending fund balance was,
okay,
or should be. And Jamie and Paul went back because I think the legislature had established a 25%, basically, is what the legislature is working towards going with that. But Emergency Management came back and established the 30% fund balance. Was that what you recall, Jamie?
Well, 30,000 was,
I didn't bring my paperwork. This isn't on the agenda. I didn't know that we were going to.
Well, it is on the agenda if we're approving a budget levy for it. I mean, that's where what we're at, is a budget levy for Emergency Management. But
yeah, the commission, you had requested that the commission have a cap so that we can just build up hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Correct.
The commission met, they determined what they thought was a good balance, and they brought that back, and that's when you guys had voted because of.
Right, and going forward, we agreed that it probably won't be a 10-cent levy all the time.
Right.
Going forward.
Yeah, but initially it was, because the main concern, of course, is still dangling with the FEMA floods of 2010, where
right,
we're missing that reimbursement, plus to cover the additional 15% that was spent, so that didn't have to come back. We'd have to come back to the city and the county and have you guys cover that 15%. That levy would help supplement the difference there as well.
If you were wanting to leave the 10-cent levy for five years, was just what the conversation
no, it was up to 10 cents.
It was up
guaranteed
to 10
not
cents.
To go past 10 cents for the 5 years.
Yeah,
right.
But what it was in the supervisor's minutes, you know, I agree there was conversation whether it was 30,000 or 30%. Well,
they're both about the same number.
30% would be more. I think 30% is going to be about $40,000 almost of what you're current budget is, so the 30% would be more than the 30,000 flat dollar amount that you had, but that's what we had, was a 30% fund balance in your budget. Well, then, so then when you published in the paper, then that's what I was going off of, was what you published in the paper, and if we levy the 10 cents on it, that would generate what you had here was $91,000 then from the county's contribution to that. But that would leave an ending fund balance of $89,753 is what you have in your ending fund balance here, which is about twice almost what, you know, what that levy is. So that's my basis. I don't have, you know, I'm not stuck up on, you know, doing, I just want to get back to, you know, where we agreed and what we did. And so from that's why I don't think the 10-cent levy, I think more a 5-cent levy would be, which would give you more of about a $45,000 ending fund balance, which would still be.
Can I see that, please, Greg?
I believe the budget is about
$86,000
a year. That there's $1,700, which is going to go towards the FEMA.
See, there's
that's
our
10 cents.
There's his budget, there's his ending fund balance that he's projecting. And so, you know, that's almost
okay,
quite a bit higher, where the 40,000 is, you know, 30% times that's going to be
right, right,
47. So
well, you're,
that's where I'm going for. And even at the five cent levy is going to generate what, 2.25 almost. It's still going to be about a 50% increase to all of the taxpayers in Mahaska County, basically, because everybody was paying $1.50 on last year's budget.
His budget's already been adopted. His commission adopted.
Yeah, but all we're doing is cutting his ending fund balance. He's just not going to have $90,000
sitting
in his bank account.
Okay,
if we cut the levy, he's just going to have half as much in his ending fund balance.
Are we missing something here, Jamie?
Yeah, we must be.
is what it's going to, what it's going to amount to.
I think what it is you're taking the EMPG grant into consideration. Because if you actually look at, granted this is what's published, because in here we don't have the EMPG, which was the grant money that was decided by the commission. They would look at what it is that Mahaska County needs to better prepare, whether it be our fire departments, our law enforcement, our radio communications, that kind of stuff. And that $28,000 would go towards, because again, that's money that comes from the federal government for that kind of stuff. But it's been, like, we haven't received checks from back in October yet. So instead of sitting around being in the red waiting on those checks, when that money came in, that would go towards the emergency response stuff. The other one in here is, like, this year we have the HSGP 2009 grant, which ends in July. So that's money that's accounted for that's not spent, because that's Homeland Security Region 5 money. And basically, that's up to them to decide what it's spent on. We're just, the commission agreed to be the fiscal agent for that. So we get that money, we budgeted for that money, and then as those requests come in, we don't have control over it. It comes from the board, and then that money is spent out. So I don't think that you're going to see an ending fund balance of $89,000 based off of $91,000 on the levy.
Your total here on this budget, well, this is 2011-2012, right? We don't have 13 numbers here.
Well, that is actually, it just isn't marked. This isn't an updated one.
Your annual budget is
these
about.
Are, yeah, these will be the same, except for this comes, actually,
but
it's already
up. Your annual budget is how much based on?
$83,000 if you take out the grants to help fund it. It's $83,029. The levy, $91,628, which was $8,600, which was going to go towards that 15% to help cover from the FEMA.
Yeah, so I believe our thinking was that, first of all, you were hand to mouth. Couldn't even pay some bills for a while, correct?
Yeah, we're still waiting for some checks.
Because we have a history of underfunding it. So that's the thinking behind the, and then changing the levy, using the levy structure rather than the per capita. So that's part of the issue. The other part of the issue is the need for emergency management to be up to par. As we witnessed in the last few days, preparedness for natural disasters is one of the fundamental responsibilities of government. We have a history of underfunding that, and it's our thinking was to get caught up, to quit underfunding it, because it's not something we should trifle with. So. I believe we need to stick with what we had decided in November, and then in subsequent years we react accordingly.
And Mr. Gordy, it was brought up at the commission meeting that there is a good possibility that 10 cents will go down next year, but we wanted to get the FEMA stuff and everything covered prior to doing so. And then again, when budget time comes around next year, we'll refigure it, and if we can drop it down, we'll drop it down.
Why is it that existed, you know, in June 30th? So what in 3 months, you have the ending fund balance of $77,829 here. So your ending fund balance still here for in just 2 or 3 months is still going to be $77,800 here.
No, we're still playing catch up. We're still in the red, correct? Yeah. And we're still waiting on EMPG money. We're still waiting on FEMA recovery money.
To cover that 77 or whatever that number is hasn't come in.
Right.
And that makes it difficult for budgeting when you're waiting for months for
Well, is it more, it's more than months, it's...
Oh, well...
It's been over a year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was something that the commission really looked at as far as what are we going to do? We can't just close down the office and wait for the checks from FEMA to come.
So what, is this the budget you have to send into the state?
Yeah, that's the one that, to the Department of Management.
It's just confusing to me how, at the end of this year, in 3 months, you know, granted, you know, they're coming in, but if you haven't received those grants, you know, or if you haven't received that money, why would you go ahead and plug it in? Because at the end of this year, you know, you're going to have 77,000, 78,000, and then at the end of next year, you're saying you're having 90,000 with administration and operations, which budget, which you have in here is your expenditures, 141,000, which, you know, 78, that's, you know, is still over 50%, because double 77 is going to be 154,000. You're still over 50% on this budget, and next year you had 138,000, you know, which, rounding it off just at 90,000, that's, you know, it just shows that your ending fund balance is increasing, and that's what I don't understand. Why we need to levy a full 10 cents, given the whole economic environment of everything here, why do we need to build ending fund balances of that?
We won't have any, and you can ask the auditor, our ending fund balance won't be that. And I actually worked with her on that, so that the number's only gonna be close to that.
The revenues aren't coming in from the federal, the state government yet. And he had to put out the expense in order to do these projects or disasters, whatever you want to call them, at the time that it happens. You can't wait a year from now to pick up the debris from the tornado that they had the other night, the other morning.
I mean, he has to submit a budget, and that's assuming that all that money comes in, but that hasn't happened and probably won't happen. That's
the issue. Yeah, I would look at the white paper. If you look at what it is that the budget takes or what the office takes,
exactly,
versus what it is that they're taking in, you'll see the ending fund balance is not going to be $77,000, especially when we're in the red right now.
I appreciate the concern, Greg. I understand
that, sir.
But when it's been underfunded for quite some time and we've had some significant draws on that fund because of disasters, and the feds are so slow getting money back. I mean, that's what we're talking about here, I believe.
And so if we do the 10 cent levy, the maximum, then on what you're saying this year, then what it'll be, we just adjust more next year or find out?
And yeah, then, the commission already said they were going to take it under review year by year inside.
And that's correct. It's up to 10 cents, and going forward, we don't expect.
Well, when the commission brought that forward, they brought it forward so that you had an idea as far as, you know, they said they wanted to lock it in. So that's why they brought it forward, so that way you know that over the next 4 or 5 years, this is where they would guarantee it wouldn't go any higher than this. But they also said they could drop it down if they could do so.
You know where it currently is, or is it something? Is it still down? Jamie, did you say there was still about 60,000 or something that was yet to be coming back in? That was what I heard 2 or 3 months ago. And then I thought you said
just got our second appeal approved. That's 40,000 plus we're still waiting on. I want to say 30,000 from EMPG, and then that's from last October's fiscal year, federal fiscal year. And then this federal fiscal year, which again started in October, they haven't even put out, they have the money appropriated at the federal level, but they haven't, and they just started putting out the stuff to the state. The state has not put out the guidance or what it is they're going to require of us, or we haven't even applied for it yet, because they don't have that information out. And again, that was from this last October. So once they get it out, then we submit the stuff, and then we'll have to, we play catch up. I mean, I just turned in fiscal October of, let's see, 2010, claims for that 3 months ago. Oops, sorry. So.
Well, if I could comment too, and then I'm gonna tie it back to Russ a little bit too, because we've had some discussion. We talked about monies being spent for things we don't benefit from. We've been part of CERG, the Southeast Iowa Response Group, for almost 20 years. In that 20 years, we spent $320,000, that's a ballpark number, for emergency response from that group. And we've used that three times in 20 years. So.
Used it as a, they stood there and said, okay, you should probably do this, and that was pretty much it, capacity yeah. too. Make sure, yeah, it wasn't a full blown response. They came, they saw, they left.
And my point is that we become, and we have a history, of course, of being part of 2080 agreements to provide these multi-county services, and that's a legitimate thing. But time, as time goes on, things change, circumstances change. Certainly emergency management has changed over that 20-year period. And that's something else, and I've commented on that before, and Jamie's working on that as we speak to review what we're doing with that. And going forward, investigate whether we should make some changes. We're at a different point on that timeline with Russ. Clearly, there's issues there that are different than when we started, but it's a little hard to extricate ourselves from all those 2080s. So I think everybody's working in good faith here, trying to stay current with what services we need, and of course keep the taxpayer dollars spend at a minimum. So if I can tie those two together, that's some of the issues we have to deal with going forward. Absolutely.
Where are we on the status with pulling out down there? Because what do we pay down there? $17,000-$18,000?
We pay $18,900 a year, something like that, I think. And, but we have to get, and Jamie's been working on that, a lot of training, certification, whatever, with the various fire departments in the county, right?
Is right.
And then at some point there's gonna be some capital expense related to that, equipment and so forth, and that's what we have to decide going forward, is whether that's the way to do it, or do we stay part of the bigger group.
And I had actually planned on having stuff you guys look at by the end of next week, so that we could get that on the supervisor's agenda again and discuss it.
Because haven't some other counties already pulled out down there?
One has pulled out, and actually, the one that's pulled out has actually talked about wanting to get our program going if we'd be interested in just doing the surrounding counties. Again, that's something I told them I didn't want to get into any of that because I want to worry about my county. So
that's a process, and since I started on CERB a year ago, we've been, you know, I guess we've been fairly open to the fact that we're evaluating where we're at with that program and going forward what we need to be doing. And I don't think we've made that decision. I sure haven't. There's some expense with doing it our thing too. And
there's a lot of equipment and infrastructure that has to be put in place to respond to some of that
yeah.
stuff. And that was the idea going with the Tumwood
yeah.
to
well, that's
and acquire some
that's
of that.
A debate for another day, but $320,000 we've spent on that over the years, and have used it three times is another way of looking at that. So
we're kind of like buying insurance. If we had all our
yeah,
insurance money back that we'd never spend either, we'd all be rich. You know, if that's the case, you know, it's kind of like going to Las Vegas
yeah.
there. But OK. Okay, so, sorry, so if I go ahead and go along with the 10 cent levy on emergency management here for this 1 year, and we look at it, you know, again next year, then my concern comes back to Russ again, because that's, Russ is where we were a year ago. When we were emergency management now is where we were with Russ a year ago, and I went ahead with supporting in the budget the $5,000 for Russ, and so I still think we need to do and pull that back, because I'm not supportive of kicking the can on down the road here. Again, we need to make a determination on with Russ on what we're going to do with that. And I think the other counties, Russ did let one county out. And so, you know, where it's going with that, and there.
Well, but there's a lawsuit. There's a lawsuit with the other one, right? And I wanted to wait to see how that was resolved, or is that?
Well, where that can go for some time, and then talking with there, I think that what may happen there is they just because of the situation with Russ and how Russ is wanting to pursue it, the only position may be to stop making the payments to Russ and let them pursue it, you know, because if we pay the $5,000 again, what are we going to get, same as we got last year? Nothing.
Question.
And how many years do we do that before, and we know we're not going to, we know we have no benefit.
I guess the question in my mind, and I do not know the answer to this, is it going to cost us more to litigate it than to find a way out of it without going through, using the courts to do it? That's my...
I think we could probably have some cooperative counties join in with us, and we could probably be a class action suit.
Okay,
you know,
and I agree, and that's why and when I start going to the meetings, I want to try to get a feel for that and see if we can do this, do it without inviting litigation and cost to the county that way. So I guess I'm simply in the position that we approve the budget. When do we normally make that payment to the pay? We can't solve that today.
I can't give you a date because
okay.
I don't know. They send us a note, and whenever they send it, we make the payment. So sometime during the fiscal year. I don't know what the date is.
And
well, what's happened in the past is there's been counties only pay $1,000, just like we did the current year we're in, but just like last year, we only gave $1,000, as well as some other counties have only given $5,000 or $1,000. Mm-hmm. So they might say that there's $5,000 annual contribution per county, but they haven't enforced that either.
Okay.
Plus, I think according to the budget, there's some other questions in regards to their obligations for us, you know, committing to that $5,000 in there that hasn't been done, you know, in the Russ agreement as well. But I think that's why my opinion, the $5,000 was in there last year. I definitely didn't sign it, but the $5,000 contribution got made. We were going to decide it this year. I think we just need to pull the money out, and if we're going to pursue exiting, you know, that was the thing. We were going to do the $5,000 last year. We're going to pursue getting out of it. We aren't any farther right now than we were a year ago. If we pull the money out, this money is budgeted for next year. We've already done it. You can go to the meeting. You can start the process here. We're still in the process. We have 15, 16 months, and the $5,000, you know, if it came that we had to do the $5,000 because we weren't able to get out, that can always be put back in,
yeah,
as a budget amendment, like a year from
your,
now.
Your point's well taken, and I don't mean to, I think we agree on this issue. For me, it was the matter of we don't have to pay the $5,000. You're saying, well, we don't have to budget the $5,000. I can live with your approach. I can live with that fine. We all know where we're heading with this thing, I think. So I can live with that.
So if
I trying to avoid being a bull in a china shop, I thought it would be nice to get a feel for what's going on there, a personal feel for that, before we gave the appearance of moving out, I guess.
But we're current on the current year.
Yeah, you're right.
We just don't budget
right
for next year, and if push comes to shove, and we have to give $1,000 or we have to give $5,000, we can
okay
do a budget amendment May.
I can live with that because you and I agree on where this thing's going, I believe. So it's a matter of how we get there. So
So either way, Ken had a motion there, but I didn't support and adopt just the thing.
I'll withdraw the motion and allow you to make a motion then if you want.
I'll make a motion that we adopt the budget with the deletion of the... Or you want a dollar amount, the $5,000 annual?
But are you going to stay with the $1,000 then, or not?
No, just drop out completely.
I just wonder what ramifications that brings with it.
Well, whether it's a $1,000, $5,000.
I think that's fine.
You know, just...
I'll support that.
And so I don't know how you wanted that in the budget, Kay, which is the easiest for your thing, with the, just the deletion of the rest.
It isn't going to make a whole big difference in the final totals. I mean, I will take it out of the line item.
Right.
And there, and the final totals that was here and here, it'll change it.
A minute here.
Yeah. But we can proceed with that change.
Half a cent difference is what it'll amount to, basically, because if one penny does $9,000, $5,000 is a half a penny, so it's about...
Yeah, it's about a half a penny.
Right.
Four and a half.
Well, by the time you get on the ground.
Yeah.
Right, so it's going...
I will take it out of the sheets in the book, and then totals and so, and I'll print new sheets for this. But as far as actually changing the levy, I don't expect it to change the levy.
It's just that we need to proceed with, not so it's an open-ended continuation on with us.
Well, but I think that's what the motion does. The motion was to approve this budget with that change, correct?
With the deletion of...
With the deletion of the $5,000.
Right, and that's what I'll do. I'll take that $5,000 out of the line item, and we'll run new numbers, but I don't expect it to change anything on this final sheet.
And we can't raise things, but we can lower them, correct?
Correct.
So, and this is in effect lowering it.
Right.
So I support that.
Okay, any other comments? If none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay.
So then I'll make some new printouts for you to sign.
And we'll both just need to sign those?
No, just you as chair.
Oh. You just need two copies of it.